Hi guys, I'm Carlo from Carlo Ceramics and welcome to the last Christmas theme video of this year. In this video, I will be showing you how to make a candle holder on the polish wheel. I will be throwing it in two different parts, which I will later on be attaching on top of each other to make the candle holder. But don't worry, just keep on watching and I'll explain everything.
I start off by centering the clay. I do this by pressing the clay to the middle of the wheel and then I cone it up and I push it down. You can repeat this multiple times until the clay is fully centered. Then I press the clay down and I start opening it up. I push my middle finger into the clay and pull it to the side. At this point you can decide whether you want to make a bottom or not. Since it's a candle holder, you don't necessarily need a bottom, but I am leaving it in, as you can see. Then I start pulling up the walls. I hold a sponge in my right hand and push towards my left hand on the inside while making an upwards movement. This way the clay becomes higher and the walls become thinner. As you can see, I hold the thumb of my left hand on the outside. This makes it easier to move both of my hands at the same time. When the cylinder is finished, I start making the shape a bit more interesting. You can of course make any shape you'd like. I'm now making the middle part of the cylinder a bit thinner. And as you can see, the top of my cylinder is a bit wobbly. You should avoid this because I will be attaching a different part on top of it. So what I do is grab my needle tool and I cut some clay off of the top. And I smooth out the rim by going over it with my fingers. And then I get rid of some excess clay at the bottom by cutting this away with a wooden knife. I also clean the bed with this. And then I start making some texture on top of the pot. As you can see, I hold two fingers on the outside and I press in between those two fingers on the inside to make this texture. I'm just playing around a little bit with this and I'm not making anything special. So just see what you'd like for yourself. And then I pull the rim a little bit outwards. And I also make a little rim by pushing my thumb into the clay at the bottom. And then I decided to make some extra lines on top of the thicker lines I already made. And then the shape is finished and I smoothed it out with a sponge. And I got rid of any slip or water that's still on the piece. And I also took out the water that was still on the inside. Then I use this tool to measure the top. If you don't have this, you can just use a normal ruler. And then this part is finished. I will now start throwing the part that will be attached on top of the previous part. I again start off with centering the clay. And then I press the clay down as far as I can. While I'm doing this, I measure if it's wide enough and if it's not, I just press it even flatter. Then I make this little point at the middle. This will prevent the candle from falling over. I do this by pressing my fingers into the clay and moving them towards each other. Then I make the bottom a bit thinner by pulling more clay towards the side. I just press my finger into the middle and then pull it horizontally towards myself. And I again measure it sometimes to see if it's wide enough. I wanted to make the point in the middle a bit sharper. I did this by just pushing my finger into the bottom part of it. And I also used this wooden knife to make it even sharper. And then on the end I start putting up the walls a little bit. I do this by pressing the clay upwards. I do this at the end because this part can actually collapse, so I wait until I finish the middle part before I do this. And then I get rid of any slip or water that's still on the piece by going over it with this sponge. And then I again get rid of some excess clay at the bottom by going over it with this wooden knife. And then this piece is finished as well. After both of the pieces has dried for a day, I start trimming them. I start off with trimming the first piece and as you can see, I'm just centering the bottom. And I also take away a little bit of clay at the side to make it round. And I give it a little foot, but you could also decide to cut out the whole bottom if you'd like, because it doesn't really have a purpose. When I'm done trimming, I do make a hole at the bottom. I do this by pressing my needle tool into it. And I smooth out the edges a little bit by using a small trimming tool. And then I go over the whole piece with a wet sponge. And I get rid of the slip by going over it with this trimming tool. And then I go over it again with my fingers to smooth it out even more. And then this piece is done. I will now be trimming the second piece. I trim this on top of the first piece because it's the easiest way to hold it. I first place it on top and see if it's centered. As you can see, it is not. So I hold my nail against it and see where it scratches, and then I move it a little bit, and you can just repeat this until it's centered enough. And then I start trimming it. You don't have to trim a lot of the bottom because this doesn't really have a purpose, because you won't see this because it will be on the inside of the piece. I do get rid of some clay at the sides by just trimming this away and making the shape a bit more round. And then I smooth it out again just like I always do. So I go over it with a sponge, and then I go over it with this trimming tool to get rid of the slip. And then I also go over it with my fingers again. And then this top piece will be placed on top of the bottom piece just like this. I will now show you how I do this. I start off with scratching the rim of the bottom part. As you can see, I scratch quite deep and quite a lot. I'm using this tool from Xeem Tools. Then I apply some vinegar all over the rim with this brush. And I scratch it again with the same tool as before. And then I place the top part onto the bottom part, and I put some pressure on it to make sure it gets stuck. Then I use a wet sponge to smooth out the edges, just like this. This might take some time, but by just going over it, it will smooth it out. And then the piece is finished and ready to dry before biscuitfire. I will now show you how I glaze this piece. I start off with 3 coats of Mulberry from Emeco. It's important to let the glaze dry in between coats. If you'd like, you can use a heat gun to speed up the drying. When I've applied 3 coats of Mulberry, I start applying the second glaze, which is seaweed. I will only apply this on the top part of the piece. And as you can see, I make a wavy line at the bottom. After the first coat has dried, I apply a second coat. And this is the final result of the candle holder.
That was it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked and you learned something new from it. If so, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet. And if you're going to make this candle holder yourself and you're going to post it on Instagram, please tag me at @ColorCeramics so I can see your work, because I really enjoy that. I hope to see you in the next video. Bye!